August 2014, a Yazidi representative makes this desperate plea for help from the Iraqi parliament.
Our women have been taken as slaves and sold into slavery at the market in Raqqa. Gentlemen, as we speak, there is a genocide going on against the Yazidis.
That was over a year ago, but the situation for one of Iraq's oldest minorities hasn't improved. 18-year-old Jinan is one of those Yazidi girls captured and sold into slavery by the Islamic State organization.
We spent 3 months in a house with the two masters who had bought me. It was a difficult time. They tortured us. They wanted to convert us by force and they demanded that we pray and read the Quran. When we refused, they beat us. They chained us outside in full sun and made us drink water with dead mice floating in it. And they threatened to use electricity to torture us.
Jinan was held for 3 months last year. Now she's written a book about her captivity. In it, she describes being taken to a slave market among dozens of other women.
The fighters circulated among us, laughing raucously, pinching our backsides. One man complained, saying, "That one has big breasts, but I want a Yazidi with blue eyes and pale skin. Those are the best, apparently. I'm willing to pay the price."
Predominantly ethnic Kurds, the Yazidis' faith is based on ancient Persian Zoroastrianism. To the Islamic State group, they are at best pagans, at worst devil worshippers. And according to its ideology, that means Yazidi men can be killed and women raped as sexual slaves.
These men are not human. They think only of death, of killing. They take drugs non-stop. They want to avenge themselves on the whole world.
Even Yazidi children are not spared. They're taken to so-called military academies where they're indoctrinated in IS ideology. The boys are taught to be soldiers, the girls about being jihadi brides. For Jinan, this story ended happily.
One day, they'd been on the front line and they came back to the house at around 8 p.m. They were tired and fell asleep. Around midnight, when we were sure they were deep asleep, the five other Yazidi women and I climbed out of the window. Thanks to a mobile phone stolen from the house, we were able to get in touch with a Yazidi fighter who guided us over the phone. We walked for 5 hours until we arrived at the foot of Mount Sinjar. There we met up with the Yazidi fighter.
But Jinan was one of the lucky ones. More than 2,000 Yazidi women and girls are still being held captive by IS, and more than 400,000 Yazidis have been displaced in the Kurdistan region. Life for them, like for Jinan, continues in refugee camps like this one.